NTD Television is launching its first ever original drama series. The 10-episode series called A Good Cop is inspired by true events. It follows the lives of three NYPD officers during the Defund the Police movement. But this show is about more than just policing. I sat down with the cast and crew members to find out more.
New York will descend into the anarchy of the 70s if we're not careful. The last thing we need is to defund the police.
My name is Cliff Labruto, and I'm playing Captain Frankie Romano in this TV series, A Good Cop.
I am Taylor Karin. I play Elizabeth Fox. Elizabeth Fox is an abolitionist turned rookie cop, which creates a really cool dichotomy.
I think you'd make a good cop.
No, I would not.
I just applied to join the NYPD.
This is betrayal.
My name is Ignacio Matinha, and I play the character Jalen Daniels on the television series A Good Cop. Jalen is a straight-edge, honest guy that can't be bought. He's a police officer with integrity, with a strong moral compass. And throughout the series, the foundations for all of his beliefs that make him that great trophy cop are tested.
So without going into any spoilers, could you tell us a bit more about the plot and what the viewers can expect from it?
So A Good Cop, we're going to delve into corruption. Corruption is going to be a big part of it. Themes of police have all this authority. Who watches the police? Who polices the police is one of the themes running through the show. And various levels of hierarchy of the government and how the police interact with it, how civilians interact with it. And what happens when or if people in power start to abuse that power? What are the checks that are there to control that?
Say you come across hard evidence that would be catastrophic to some really powerful people, and now they're threatening you. What would you do? I make a discovery that is so incredible, it's so outlandish that, I mean, it affects emotionally the police that are working on it. And they become very motivated because of the content of this discovery to do things that and go places that they wouldn't ordinarily go.
From what I understand, a lot of these stories are based on real life, and you did try to make sure that this was as authentic as possible to the policing, particularly in New York. So how did you make sure that these scenes and what you were doing was authentic?
Research, research, research.
Having former police officers among the cast members also helped, like Patrick Herity, who plays Sergeant Pico.
90% of the time I spent on set with A Good Cop, I was with David. And we spoke a lot about police situations. We think alike. And he really did his homework. He did a lot of research.
Action.
He interviewed a lot of police officers. He was interviewing me daily.
So what sort of themes and values can viewers expect to see when watching this series?
Sticking to your values in the face of extreme adversity and danger.
A Good Cop explores the themes of right and wrong, justice. It really tries to not tell you what to think about it, but have these characters that are part of the storyline go through different situations that test them and make them have to make difficult decisions. And that's really how you discover what is a good cop or a good person, is what kind of choices do they make when they're tested.
A good cop is actually a question mark. It's not an exclamation point. It's not like a, yes, we did it. It's, what does that mean? What does that mean to you? Does that feel like a fantasy? Do you feel protected? And how do you feel watching something like this? It's a conversation starter.
What can this medium of film bring to this conversation that we might not be able to see just through dialogue or through what we see in the media of either talking point on the issue of policing?
What you see on the news or social media is that one person says, I hate police, they're murderers. This person says, well, I have people, friends that are police and they're not that. And then these people just never can get past that and talk about it in a more logical, rational way. When you have a story-based way to explore the issue, I'm not really looking for a black and white answer. I'm just like, well, these police or these characters that happen to be police in these situations. Let's see what happens. And as we follow them, we kind of can understand why they make their choices, even if you don't agree with it. So it's putting you inside the shoes of these police officers, and that, I think that's the power of story versus just fighting it out on social media.
What I love about the show is that it has such a diverse storyline for every character. They're all thinking differently, they're all going through something different, they all have different, you know, perspectives on life, and having that diversity, I think, is going to be extremely relatable to a lot of people, so hopefully it'll bridge that gap.
I think a good cop will force people to step outside of their comfort zone and test out a point of view that they're not used to necessarily believing in. You know, like I always say, there's three sides of a story. There's your side, there's my side, and then somewhere in the middle there's the truth. And I think what this show does is we try to step inside that middle area and find the truth and present it to the audience in a way where they can really understand and resonate with the characters.
What's this I hear about you two and internal affairs?
Oh, well, we walked into a sting operation.
There are a lot of cop shows, but this does have a unique perspective. You'll learn things that you probably did not know before.
Anything to say about firearms there, Miss Corruption?
No.
The first episode of A Good Cop airs on Sunday, the 5th of December at 7:30 p.m. Eastern. Be sure to tune in.